Hey, horse people. Well, no stupid human lets their horse get away. Saddle, obviously, saddle was put on wrong, inappropriately, or the rider didn't know how to ride, slid off, and pulled the saddle down. And of course, anytime the rider falls off, the horse is on his own. So this horse is scared. It's got a saddle underneath it. And I've showed you in quite a few of my sacking out videos, I turn my saddle upside down like this on my horse. Now, that doesn't mean they're not going to run if it ever happens, but it does mean they've been exposed to it and they know it's not the end of the world and it may help them calm down and not run. Normally, when a rider falls off, it spooks a horse. They're not used to it happen. They get in pain. They're dragged. Something caused the rider to fall off, maybe a spook, unlevel ground, something. So the horse naturally runs anyway. Then as he's running, this thing's underneath him and it's hard for him to refocus that I've been here before. But anyway, this guy... I've got the sound muted because I can't. It's just the motorcycle running. I wanted to point out, you can tell this guy, he's trying to do good. A lot of people kill horses trying to help. I say it all the time. People kill horses trying to help because they don't know what they're doing. So this motorcycle racer is trying to capture him, but he's not getting in front of the drive line because he doesn't understand a drive line. He's staying behind the drive line, which is actually pushing the horse to run. He's not creating this horse to shut down. He should be in front of it, weaving in front of it so the horse can't run past him and the horse will slow down. That would be the way to stop and slow down this horse to get him to slow down. But he's running behind the drive line. You're going to notice right here is the drive line and he stays behind it. And he's doing the same thing you would do if you were in a round pen or chasing a horse. If I want a horse to move, or if I move my horses on my motorcycle, this is exactly where I'm at because I'm behind the drive line and I'm pushing a horse. This rider doesn't know that. So he chases the horse quite a way. Cars aren't even stopping, which I'm kind of shocked. What bugs me here is there is a rail over here where this horse is running, so the motorcycle has trapped the horse between the roadway and the rail. Instead of getting on the other side of the horse, and there's open pasture, and pushing the horse to the grass area off the road, that would have solved the problem. That would have helped the horse. Again, people get caught up when they see a horse, they want to chase. And chasing a horse rarely ever causes a horse to stop running. Matter of fact, I'm not sure I've seen a video where someone was chasing a horse and they stopped running. But anyway, motorcycle's chasing him, putting pressure. He wants to slow. See, when he gets in front of the horse a little bit, the horse slows. Right here, he cut off his drive line. He doesn't even know he cut off the drive line, but he went in front of the horse just enough to cut off that drive line. See, I got past and he's cutting off the drive line. Not sure he's even knowing it. And he cuts this drive line off and the horse turns away. So if he understood pressure and release when he was chasing a horse, he could have stopped the horse a long time ago, but he didn't. He was trying to get behind it so he could reach out and grab the reins. If you're trying to reach from behind and grab the reins, you're putting pressure on this drive line, which is the shoulder neck area of the horse. So here he gets him off. Again, if he would have came back over here and put pressure here, he would have kept the horse off the road. Instead, he gets behind the horse, pushes the horse forward, goes straight at the horse, again, straight at him, pushing them into the roadway, hand reached out, grabbing, predatory behavior, not good. Helmet on. Looks like a meat-eating predator, scary, freaking, you know, trapezoid alien coming to eat me. Not too many horses are going to let you approach them with a helmet and mask on with your glove out trying to grab them. That's just a clue. Most horses aren't going to let you approach them that way. Rick, why are you picking on a guy? He's trying to help. I'm not picking on him. I'm trying to educate the dummies that won't see what the problem is. People just want to see, oh, what a great guy. He's trying to help. He's going to get the horses killed because he doesn't know what he's doing, and he's making the situation worse. He does end up catching a horse, by the way. But I want you to notice the horses aren't running. Rick, why aren't they running? Because nobody's chasing them. Nobody's putting pressure on them. It's only when people put pressure on them do they leave and start running again. Rick, why he's trying to help? You're just being mean. Okay, here we go. It's my fault because people don't know what they're doing with a horse. And I pointed out. All right, so the guy ends up catching up to the horse. And he doesn't notice that every time he gets beside or in front of the horse slows down. You can tell the horse changed when he gets right in front of it just a little bit. The horse will slow. But he doesn't know this. The horse is tired. The horse doesn't want to run. See the horse slowing? He looked at him. He's in front of him and the horse looked at him. If he just moved over in front of the horse with the motorcycle, the horse would slow down. Rick, he doesn't know that. You're just being mean. Oh, be quiet, you big crybabies. And I will give him credit that it's hard to, this is the throttle. So every time he reaches for the horse, he pulls off the throttle, which means the bike slows down. So he's got to go fast enough so he can reach off one of the gas and then use his other brake to slow down afterwards. And he grabs a horsey. He tries to slow down a little too fast and pulls a horse. If he slowed down a little bit slower, he'd have been better. But he pulled the horse so fast by the bit, by the pain, yanked the horse in front of him. That's the only thing he could do. He got the horse in front of him. He kind of hits the horse. The horse jumps, pulls him off his bike. He hangs onto the reins and saves the horse. Yay! Happy ending. Ricky saved him. Why are you being mean to him? I'm not being mean to him, you big dummies. He's trying to help the guy. And he does. He ends up catching him. But first of all, who's ever riding in a big bit with the nose band tells me they don't know what they're doing. Had a damn English saddle. Every English saddle. You ever notice that every time you see horses running around wildly in an arena or somewhere where it's dangerous, they always have an English saddle on, nose band, and a bit. When was the last time you saw a horse running wildly with a Western saddle? I'm not saying all Western riders are great. I'm not saying that at all. I'm just saying that the idiots that claim to know the most with all their fancy gear usually know the least. Anyway, the guy caught the horse. Good job. Could have done it quicker. Could have done it safer. Could have done it better. I don't know if he'd learn from this or not. If he saw a horse run next day, he'd probably do the same thing. Why? Because it worked, Rick. Just because something works doesn't mean it's good for the horse. All right? We'll end that there. A couple of lessons. Good little horsey, poor thing. All right. Buddy, Miss T, you're good boys.